You know, I'm not even sure that HGTV got my application reel last time. You know, there's no way of knowing that it actually even got there. So to say that they didn't hire me would be an erroneous comment assumption. Because I don't even know if it showed up at their desks. And I think Home and Garden, probably full of a room full of nice people who appreciate nature. So I think probably it's likely that they just didn't get a chance to take a look. And I think what I'm going to do today in my second reel is just add a splash of color to my face. A pop of color, as they might say. You know, persistence and confidence are kind of the same thing, as well as a little bit of obsessiveness. And that's okay. You know, Gwyneth got where she is today through confidence and seaweed. And I think we've learned a lot about that from her. You know, we're going to keep it clean, but we're going to keep it rosy. A little fiery red on the face never hurt. You know, I tend to be a little red anyway because of my my ancestry prefers the indoors. But we're going to head outside. Just gotten real into bright colors, you know? Colors of nature. I mean, nature is color and science. And mostly carbon, from what I understand. Make sure that's... Does that sound like a... We don't really understand each other, so we just talk through signals. Gustav, if you don't mind, we'll just sit in this tulip patch. You just, maybe a higher angle. A higher angle is great for the face and the part of me that needs to be speaking. You know what I mean? Okay. So these are spring tulips. These are what grow in the ground when a person comes along and plants them in the front of their house, basically. This microphone pack is making me, I'm afraid it makes me look a little, I don't need to focus, it's fine. You just stick right here. I need to look as good as I can this time so that they watch the tape. And nature is really important because nature is what gives us the instinct to not die. And that's how I think of it. Nature is also the thing that makes, you know, television itself. I mean, without nature, we wouldn't have the science of the arts. We'll get a shot of me kind of running into flowers or running away from flowers. Or I know this isn't safe, mostly for me because of my allergies, but you know, I really appreciate any work you can do for me. I didn't like that. We're through. We're in the gardening arena. Should I just boom myself or?
Yeah, I follow.
Don't talk to me. You know what, just hand me things. It's about springtime now, I think, and that's what they call it in the gardening world. And unfortunately there's a large plane overhead. We'll just listen. Oh, well, here we go. Here is a purple, I don't know, it's more of a weed. You know, sometimes you gotta just, it's in the interpretation. To one man's flower is another man's problem. Gustav, I wish that you would just get more familiar with my process so we didn't have to go through this every time for every channel, every weekend. You know, this weather reminds me of the playground in school. You know, the kids would pick the grassy leaves and kind of rub them on my pants. Make it look like I'd grassed myself. And some of the other kids would throw bees at me. You know, I just want to make a plea directly to Home and Garden and let you know that I'm a real hard worker. I'm pretty crafty as well, so if you're looking for kind of a gardening and craft show, home decorating is something I've always, I haven't enjoyed it per se, but I've seen it. And I think the mark of a true Home and Garden host person is that they can just roll with the punches. I can't believe this f***ing school bus is so, it's so inappropriate. Why is there so much diesel fuel, fossils fuel? It's terrible things for the nature, science. I think if you look look in my eyes, HGTV. He'll know what I'm saying. And what I'm saying is that I love the outdoors.